Antichrist? Was Jesus God in flesh and blood? These are some of the questions answered in the letters of John. From the beginning, God has been love. From the first day, God has been light. In the beginning, God set the table to have flesh and blood fellowship with us, as real as bread and wine. And this fellowship would be our eternal life. God was the host, the garden was the table, and the honored guest was his chosen bride. And she, the elect lady, was to taste, she was to feast, she was to touch, hear, smell, and see all that God's love and light had brought to the table in his hospitality. But from the beginning, there was also an enemy. Someone who denied God's love, who called his hospitality a lie. He was against the host, against his table. He was anti-fellowship, anti-light. And she, the elect lady, the chosen bride, was defeated by darkness, was taken away from her eternal life with one inhospitable bite. From the beginning, this anti-light and deceiver has sought to deceive her and keep her from God's table fellowship of bread and wine. This is why Jesus came in the flesh, to host a table of love and light, to invite the world to touch, to hear, to smell, to see that he would host his chosen bride. He would be God's chosen Christ. He would give his body to be their bread and his blood to be their wine. His sacrifice would be the means of providing once again for his bride's eternal life. That was what it meant for Jesus to be Christ. And one of the participants in that first feast, one of the first guests to receive Jesus' hospitality, was the Apostle John, who would go on to write and to preach that the love and light of God that existed from the beginning has come in flesh and blood to bring us back to that first feast. As people started to believe in this light and receive the love Jesus the host made available, fellowship with God began to take place once again around a table. God's people were hospitable, showing the hospitality of their host to those who believe that God came in flesh and blood to host us through Christ. And as they did, they lived in the light. As they did, they experienced their eternal life. But some who came to sit at their table, who received their hospitality and their invite, did not believe that Jesus came in flesh and blood. In fact, it was something they denied. They were enemies to God's love, anti-fellowship, anti-light. And since they were against the truth of who Jesus was, they were called anti-Christs. From the beginning, there has been an enemy, and these teachers followed in his line to deceive the elect lady who is God's chosen bride. With the flesh and blood of Christ questioned, those around the table wondered if there was still a light. So John, who had touched, heard, and seen the light, would write. He wrote a letter to remind those around the table that Jesus was as real as bread and wine. The first letter of John revealed that their own love proved the reality of Christ. Their love for each other was all the proof they needed that Jesus is the light. Because their love was as real as flesh and blood, they can know Jesus is as real as bread and wine. When they hospitably host as God's chosen bride, they prove the reality of God's chosen Christ. But what happens when hospitality and the enemy meet? For others came to their table. More antichrists were given a seat. Were God's people meant to play host to darkness? Were lies meant to be something they hospitably greet? John's second letter provided the answer. Anyone who teaches that Jesus did not come in flesh and blood has no place at the table set by God and His Son. These people are not to be received. For anyone who greets them with hospitality has fellowship with the enemy. Opposingly, there were some who would not fellowship with those who taught correctly. So John's third letter singled out a man named Diotrophes. John called out his inhospitality and showed that those who taught the truth, those who had fellowship with the light, Diotrophes treated with hate, making him look like an antichrist. For it is not only what you believe, but how you treat those who walk in the light that reveals whether or not you have a seat at the table with Christ. From the beginning, there has been an enemy to God's elect lady, His chosen bride. And with so many anti-love, anti-light, anti-church, anti-Christs, what hope do we have to overcome them into eternal life? But John reminds Jesus' bride that we have already overcome these enemies through the bread and the wine. For Jesus was overcome by his enemies. The light of the world was brought to darkness. The love that was from the beginning was thrown before all the hate of the heartless. The enemies that always pursued the elect lady had finally captured her final son. With finality, they would deny God's light and love by putting his eternal life to death in flesh and blood. For though we did not first love God, He did first love us. And this has been forever proven when the bread of His flesh was broken and when He poured out the wine of His blood. From the beginning, God has been love. From the first day, God has been light. God has set the table to have flesh and blood fellowship with us, as real as bread and wine. This fellowship is our eternal life. Jesus is our host, and we are his honored guest. We are his chosen bride. Hey everybody, David here with Spoken Gospel. Thank you so much for watching our video overviewing the letters of John, 1st, 2nd, 3rd John. We are Spoken Gospel. We are a ministry dedicated to coming alongside Bible readers to explain what they're reading in the Bible and how it all points to Jesus. And you can join us in that ministry. You can watch all of our free resources over at our website, SpokenGospel.com, or you can help make these videos possible by becoming a one-time or monthly donor. All of that is available for you online at our website, SpokenGospel.com.